You might have heard of the tragedy of Dyatlov Pass, but did you know that there was a scarier incident that actually provides an eyewitness to the horror that beset this unrelated group of hikers? Once again, we are off to Siberia, but this time we are in the middle of the summer, and 6 of the 7 hikers that began the journey will soon be dead. The lone survivor will provide terrifying details of the excursion that might create more mystery than the famed Dyatlov Pass incident. In reality, these 6 hikers died violently in a matter of minutes, spasming on the ground while bleeding profusely from their noses and mouths. The lone survivor, Valentina, was forced to flee down the mountain with few supplies. Now that is Freaky Deaky. If you like stories like this, please hit the like and subscribe button below. Let's go over some of the details so that you can decide what happened. Lyudmila Ivanova Korovina was the group leader. She was 41 years old, an experienced hiker whose somewhat survivalist methods would later come under scrutiny. Yet the devotion and admiration of the hikers that worked with her might show that she wanted her fellow hikers to be tough and prepared. One of her former students would say, quote, "She knew how to unite everyone, make a team." How many, thanks to her, became excellent teachers, athletes, created families, learned to play the guitar, draw, become stonier, bolder, more correct. We were all like foster children to her. She worried about everyone. So obviously, it seems like Lyudmila was an accomplished hiker and caring. The other hikers, Tatiana Filipenko, 24, Alexander Sasha Kryson, 23, Denis Shvatskin, 19, Victoria Vika Zalasova, 16, Timur Bapanov, 15, and Valentina Valya Udenchenko, 17, was the sole survivor. The weather was predicted to be good, so the group set off the morning of August 2nd. There were other hiking groups in the area, including one being led by Ludmila's 16-year-old daughter. Mother and daughter planned to have their groups meet up at the bottom of the pass. The predicted good weather turned out to include unexpected freezing rain and snow showers. The Korovina group hiked through various areas until on August 4th, the group paused between the peaks of Folets Jagiellni, sorry if that's wrong, and Tritons. They chose to camp on a slope about 4 kilometers from the forest edge, which would have provided more shelter in bad weather. During the night, the group endured a violent thunderstorm. On the morning of August 5th, there was fresh snow on the mountains and the weather was poor. The 7 hikers began their descent down the slope. But almost immediately, the strongest of the hikers, Alexander Kryson, collapsed, bleeding profusely from his nose, ears, and mouth. Moments later, he was dead. Lyudmila Korovina ordered her stunned group to continue down the slope as quickly as possible. She chose to stay with Sasha's body. The hikers descended a short distance down the slope, but came rushing back when they heard Lyudmila calling for help. When they got to her side, they found that she was dying as well. Some say it was a heart attack, while others say she was experiencing the same symptoms as Sasha. The group panicked as they began to be struck down by the same symptoms. 2 of the girls collapsed, tearing at their clothes and twitching. The group's lone survivor reported, quote, "Dennis began to hide behind the rocks and run away. Tatiana was banging her head against stones. Victoria and Timur probably went mad," end quote. When she tried to recover Victoria Zalasova, one of the youngest in the group, the girl bit her. Valentina Udenchenko and Denis Shvatskin were the only 2 sane hikers at this point. Denis told Valentina to grab essentials from her backpack before yelling at her to abandon it and run. When Valentina looked up from her backpack, she saw that Denis had collapsed and was bleeding. Valentina ran. She made it to the bottom of the mountain and found shelter in the woods all night through bad weather. The next morning was calm, so Valentina went back up the mountain to find her friends. There are some reports that she found Lyudmila still alive. But most likely, all the hikers' dead bodies were found scattered everywhere. Traumatized, Valentina struck off on her own, searching for rescue for 3 days. Once rescued, Valentina was in such a state of shock and weakened that she could not speak or respond to others. A search was immediately launched for the remaining hikers, but it was tough sledding as the bodies were not recovered until the end of August. The bodies were badly decomposing, contorted, and grimacing horribly. A search described the bodies as being without eyes. Why did 6 young and healthy people fall down dead? According to the autopsy, hypothermia played a role in their deaths. The bodies appeared to suffer from protein deficiency, despite having eaten well during the trip, and bruising of the lungs. But what caused their intense illness in the first place? What caused such violent fits? What killed young, healthy Sasha Kreisen in a matter of seconds and overcame the rest of the group shortly thereafter? Nearly 30 years later, this tragedy remains a visceral pain for all involved. The tourist's surviving family members have difficulty speaking of the tragedy. Lone survivor Valentina Udenchenko is still traumatized by this tragedy and refuses to speak of it. What do you think happened to the Korovina group? Once again, let us know what you think happened to this group of hikers in the comments below. If this is the type of thing you like to hear about, do us a favor and hit the like and subscribe buttons below. You can also hear us dive deeper into subjects like this on the Freaky Deaky podcasts. Find it wherever you get your podcasts. A big thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned for more. Did I not just name all six of them like perfectly? And then as soon as we start recording, like Lyudmila was an accomplished hiking caring. So obviously, it seems like Lyudmila was an accomplished hiker caring. Is that right? She was an accomplished hiker caring. There were other hikers. Yeah, I thought so too. I was like, were found everywhere. Dead bodies. All the hikers' dead bodies were found everywhere. Scattered about. Something like that. All right. What do you think happened? No.